we're going to talk about the disk method. The disk method is a way of finding volume for a solid of revolution. A solid of revolution is when you have a function, this one right here, and you revolve it around some line. When you do this, it makes a solid, and every cross section of that solid is a circle. Therefore, we can use the slice, approximate, and integrate method. As we talked about before, we know we can find volume if we integrate the area of the cross sections. With the disk method, with a solid of revolution, those cross sections are just always circles. If we look at this example here, here's your function, and when you revolve it around, this is your solid of revolution, and we can change the little rectangle and see how it changes to a different circle. And we can notice that that radius of the circle with a solid of revolution is always going to be the distance from the function to the axis. So using the method we did before, we said that we needed to find the area. We know area is pi radius squared, and we're slicing perpendicular to the x-axis, so we need to find the radius in terms of x. And now we can see that in the disk method, this is always going to be the distance from the function to the axis. So in this particular case, that looks like f of x minus 0 for this picture, because it's revolving around the axis y equals 0. And so we could put this all together and say that the volume is going to be the integral from a to b of pi f of x squared dx. But note that we could actually do this even around another axis. We would just have to subtract whatever number that is. Now we also could do the disk method if we were revolving around the y-axis or around another vertical line. The picture would look slightly different. You might have something like this, and you would revolve it around this way. But you would still get your cross sections being circles. They would just be sliced perpendicular to the y-axis. So we would still use pi radius squared, but now our radius would be the distance between the function g of y and our axis. Here's an example. We have the function y equals 1 minus 1 16th x squared from negative 4 to 4, and we're revolving it around the x-axis. So we look at a typical slice, we revolve it around, and we see the circle, and we just integrate the area of that circle. So we have the integral from negative 4 to 4 of pi radius, which is in this case the function, 1 minus 1 16th x squared. It's the distance from the function to the axis, and the axis is at 0. So pi radius squared dx. And that's all there is to it. Now what would happen if we were to do the same region, but we move the axis down to negative 2? Note that our rectangle no longer touches our axis. So if we revolve it around, we get a circle, but with another circle cut out of the middle. This is called a washer, because it kind of looks like a washer that you'd use with nuts and bolts. And we can find the volume of the solid of revolution just the same way. We just need to use the area of a washer instead of the area of a circle. Now, the area of a washer is going to be the area of the big circle minus the area of the small circle. So that's going to turn into pi outer radius squared minus pi inner radius squared. So r is the distance from the further away function to the axis, and little r is the distance from the closer function to the axis. So once again, if we put that all together and we're going around the x-axis, we're going to get a picture that looks like this. And we're going to get volume is equal to the integral from a to b of pi outer radius in terms of x squared minus pi inner radius in terms of x squared dx. Or if we revolve around the y-axis, we're going to get the integral from c to d of pi outer radius in terms of y squared minus pi inner radius in terms of y squared dy. So there's a summary. So now if we try this example, we're looking at the integral from negative 4 to 4 of pi, the outer radius, which is this distance right here. So this is the distance from the farther away function to the axis. So this would be 1 minus 1/16 x squared minus my axis, which is negative 2. So remember, vertical distances are top minus bottom, squared minus pi inner radius squared. So the inner radius is going to be this distance right here. So there's the closer function, the bottom of our region, minus the axis. So this is the function 0 minus the axis negative 2 dx.